Check this out. I'm just taking the time to just talk about this a little bit more, you know, but like, look at this, how nice it is to work with a configuration of hive design that is innately suitable and attuned to the preferences of the bee. You know, here is a beautiful 13.5-inch comb that perfectly encompasses the brood nest in an ideal fashion, in that it's enough space for them to make a brood nest of the size of their liking, leaving also room for things like peripheral drone brood, but also leaving enough room for a band of pollen, but notably not much bigger, right? See, because we used to run a foundationless system with a 16-inch comb, and it created worlds of problems for us. And it took us a few years of working with them to realize what we didn't like about them. It took us a few more years to stop using them. And so we spent a long time thinking and reading and studying about the measurements associated with a temperate colony and overhead storage of honey space and all of that science behind the suitable cavity for a bee comb. And so by limiting your comb size to something more along the size of a 13-inch comb, you limit the ability of the bees to put very much honey overhead on the actual brood frame. For us, that's important because when we used to use a 16-inch frame, they would make a fat band of pollen across the top, and then they would often not bother to cross it. And so you would put a super overhead, hoping to make a surplus for yourself, and you would get none. They wouldn't even come into the box. Instead, they would fill out every last square inch of the cavity that they had that was 16 inches in depth, and then they would start backfilling the brood nest, sometimes even finding themselves honeybound by midsummer rather than using a super. It was really frustrating. And so we had to do some reading and do some thinking and realize here we are now with a 13-inch frame that still encourages the bees to put the honey overhead in a super, which we leave for them. And occasionally, they will rear brood up in there for a short period of time in the year, and we use that as an opportunity to make a split with this super right here. But oftentimes, the perfect nature of the organization of this foundationless brood nest is completely satisfactory to them. And there's a much higher rate of them not even bothering to put brood in to supers, which does make making splits more tricky, where we have to use two boxes and divider boards to make splits from a frame like a comb like this. It's not our preference, but we do that sometimes with really stuffed out colonies that don't have brood in their supers. So this is a great system for us. It allows us to get them to put honey overhead where